Watching this tutorial, you will not only know what tokenization is, but you will also learn how to tokenize your textual datasets using PyTorch Deep Learning Framework. So first of all, what is tokenization? So tokenization is the process of breaking down, let's say, a sequence of tests into smaller units. And this unit is usually called tokens. These tokens can also further be divided into words, phrases, or characters. And all of this depends on the specific tokenization strategy used. So in the world of natural language processing, NLP for short, tokenization is a fundamental step in textual data processing. Before we start implementing tokenization using PyTorch, I want to show you how it looks like using the OpenAI tokenizer. So over here, you can just enter some text. For instance, if I enter with PyTorch, tokenization becomes easy. This is how our word is tokenized. So at the down here, you can see each word is separated into a smaller chunk. So you can see our token count right here, which specifies that we are having 8 tokens and 38 characters. And if I add more words, we'll get more tokens and more characters as well. So here what I'll do is that with PyTorch, tokenization becomes easy, and let's say everyone can do it. When I come back to the down here, you can see this has also been tokenized as well, and now our token count is 14 and total characters is 64. So with this out of the way, let's now move back to PyCharm and see how we can use the PyTorch framework to perform tokenization. For this, all I'll need you to install is Torch Test. Torch Test will help us to perform several NLP tasks. But in today's tutorial, we are just going to perform tokenization, which is very easy and straightforward. So all you need is to install Torch Test, and the code together with the requirement.txt will be on my GitHub repository, where you can just leverage it and use it in your projects. So in my main.py here, I'll import the tokenizer from Torch Test. So from Torch Test .data.utils, we are going to import get tokenizer. Okay, so this is the only import we'll be doing so far, because tokenization is something which is pretty easy to do using the PyTorch framework. And at the down here, we'll have to put out some text that will be tokenizing. So I'll just do text, and this text is equal to with PyTorch, tokenization becomes easy, and let's see, and everyone can do it. So this is the text we'll be tokenizing, or we'll be breaking down into sequence of smaller units called tokens. So now we have our text to tokenize. All we need to do now is to initialize a tokenizer that we'll be using. So I'll just call this one tokenizer. And this is equal to our get tokenizer, and over here we need to specify the particular tokenizer that we'll be using. So we just type in basic _English here, and that's it. Then after this, we just have to send our test into this tokenizer, and this will return to us our tokens. So we'll say our tokens here is equal to our tokenizer. And inside this tokenizer, you have to give it your test you want to tokenize. This will return to you your tokens. So we can just go ahead and print these tokens. And this will give us our result. So I'll just run this. And let's see what we get. All right. So guys, you can see we have our test being tokenized. So you can see this returns us a list with each element being a token. So wheat is one, PyTorch is another, tokenization is another, and so on. So this is pretty simple how you can perform tokenization using the PyTorch framework. This is very important because this is the process you need to follow, or this is one of the basic approach you need to follow when you want to build any textual model. Let's say now we have large language models there which have been built using a lot of textual data. This is one of the basic process they follow before bringing out such model. So it's very good to know how to tokenize textual data using any deep learning framework, but in our case we are using PyTorch. In the upcoming tutorial, we also learned another step that we use when you want to train your own model using textual data, and this will be word embedding. So after tokenization, what follows will be embedding your text, and watch out for that tutorial because that's going to be the next tutorial on this channel. If you love this tutorial, give me a thumbs up and also share it with people who might need this. Thanks for watching, and as usual, I'll see you in the next tutorial.